Hello everyone. Let's talk about the database management in this lecture. First, I will give you an overview about what a database consists of. Secondly, I will talk about a very important concept, the entity relationship database design, or the ER database design. Sometimes ER database design is called by some people as the entity relational database design. All of them refer to the same concept, ER database design, entity relationship design, or the entity relational database design. They are basically the same. Under the ER database design, we have two very important concepts, the primary key concept and the foreign key concept. We will focus on these two concepts today. Along the discussion, I will also talk about the process of normalization. As long as you understand the primary key and foreign key, you can perform the normalization process, because we will use the primary key and the foreign key to change a poorly designed database into a well-structured database. This process is called a normalization. First, let's take an overview about what a database consists of. A database is a software that consists of four major components: data tables, metadata, queries, forms, and reports. We are very familiar to data tables, right? Because we use Microsoft Excel spreadsheet software a lot. A data table consists of columns and rows. A column is a category of relevant information. For instance, we record all of our customers' last names in the last name column in a data table. A data row records the transaction data in detail. For instance, if we opened an e-commerce website, once a customer places an order, we need to record the customer's first name, last name, what kind of product he bought, his mailing address, contact information in one row. The second component of a database is metadata. Metadata are some information that describes the properties of the data tables, data values, and database. For instance, if you have a column called last name column in the data table, and you specify that the maximum number of characters that each cell in the last name column can hold is 20, then the value 20 is a metadata. It describes how many characters the database user can input in the last name column. The other two components of a database are queries, forms, and reports. A query is a process of looking for answers in the database by using certain keywords or standards. A form is an interface for user to input data into the data table and the database. And reports are the analysis results from the database. We will focus on query and form designs when we move to the Microsoft Access training. Today we will focus on the fundamental concept, the primary key and the foreign key concept. Before I introduce these two concepts to you, let me ask you a question. Suppose a software developer is designing a database for an e-commerce website. In this database, the e-commerce website wants to record the customer's information and the customer's order information. Currently, the software developer will record all the information, including the customer's first name, last name, contact information, mailing address, and what this customer bought from the e-commerce website into one data table. Do you think this is a good data management process? Why or why not? Let me give you about 1 minute to think about your answers, and then I will share the answers with you. This database design is a correct way. However, it is not an effective way. because it will bring the data redundancy issue to the database. What do I mean by data redundancy issue? According to this developer's design, every time when a customer places an order on this e-commerce website, we have to record this customer's personal information and order information once. Some information is new. For instance, product names and prices are different in different orders. But the other information is not new. For instance, the customer's first name, last name, contact information, and mailing address are already known. So why do we have to record the same information over and over again? If we do, the result will be we have a very large database with a lot of redundant information. So how can we change the database design and improve the performance of the database? We separate the customer information and order information into two tables. In the customer information table, we only record the customer's personal data, such as the customer's name, phone number, and mailing address. In the order information table, we only record the data about the customer's order transactions. For instance, what the customers bought on this website? What is the price for the product? In the customer information table, when we record the information about a new customer, we give a unique ID number to this customer. As you can see in the customer information table, we have a column of these unique values, 1 and 2. We call this value primary key. These are the ID numbers that can help us to find a unique customer in the customer information table. We also have primary keys in the order information table, right? They are the ID number 1 to 4 in the order ID column. These values can help us to identify a unique order transaction. But the order information table look a little different from the customer information table. Besides the order IDs, we have some customer IDs. We call these customer IDs foreign keys. A foreign key can also help us to find a unique data record. However, this unique data record is in another data table. For instance, the customer ID in the order information table can help us to find a unique customer in the customer information table. Therefore, the function of a primary key is to help us to find a unique data record. The function of a foreign key is to help us to find a unique data record in another table and create the connection between the two tables in a database. And the process of using primary key and foreign key to design a database is called an entity relationship database design. What is an entity? Each data table in a database is called an entity. What is the relationship? It is the logical connection that a foreign key created between two tables, just like what we did in the previous example. That's why we call ER database the entity relationship database design. And the process of changing a poorly designed database into an ER database is called a normalization process. What is the benefit of using an ER database design? As you can see in the order information table, instead of recording the customer's personal information, such as the customer's names, phone numbers, and addresses over and over again, we only need to record one ID number. We can simplify the data records in the order information table. Sometimes a database could be highly complicated. Is there any easier way for us to figure out which column holds the primary keys, which column holds the foreign keys? People like shortcuts nowadays, right? We have a shortcut for six packs. We have a shortcut for foreign language learning and other shortcuts all over the internet. Is there any shortcut for us to differentiate a primary key column from a foreign key column? There is a shortcut. In order to find if a column is a primary key column, you have to check if the values are unique in that column. Why is that? Because if you look at the definition of a primary key, it will help us to find a unique data record in a data table. Therefore, the primary key value itself should be unique. Otherwise, how can a primary key help us to find a unique data record? It's easier to find the primary key in the first table, right? Because we only have one ID column. And these numbers are unique. Therefore, ID is the primary key column for the customer information table. It could be a little challenging when you differentiate which one is primary key column, which one is foreign key column in the order information table. But remember the shortcut. The values in the primary key column should be unique. Therefore, you can find out the order ID is the primary key column for the order information table because there is no repeated value in the order ID column. But there are some repeated values. For instance, we have three ones in the customer ID column. Therefore, customer ID is not a primary key. I also posted some primary key exercise on eCollege. Please practice according to the definition of primary key, foreign key, or the shortcut to find the answer. This concludes this lecture. I will see you soon in the next one.